Just when liberals thought that all hope was lost, when the Russia investigation was turning out to be a big dud after a full year, after their new tactic of accusing President Trump of being mentally unfit for office was backfiring and only exposing them as being the ones who are mentally ill, now they've found their new savior who will lead them to the promised land in 2020. Oprah Winfrey. As I'm sure you heard, she got recruited by Hollywood on Sunday at the Golden Globes, and she already has the endorsement of NBC, which posted that they have, quote, nothing but respect for our future president in this now-deleted tweet. But that wasn't the only big news to come out of the Golden Globes this year. The celebrities have finally found the source of all of America's problems. Straight white men. Here's host Seth Meyers saying that while all the stars had to work really hard to get to the positions that they're in today, the women had to work extra hard, and so it's time for us men to take a back seat and let them run the industry, the country, and our lives.
People in this room worked really hard to get here, but it's clearer now than ever before that the women had to work even harder. So thank you for all the amazing work that you've all done and you continue to do. I look forward to you leading us into whatever comes next. So thank you so much for letting me say that.
Wait a minute, did he just say thank you for letting me say that?
So thank you so much for letting me say that.
Thank you for letting me say that I want you to rule over us. Oh, but his cucking didn't stop there. After his monologue, he was quite concerned that the first presenters were gonna be two white men.
And now to present our first award. Oh, please don't be two white dudes. Please don't be two white dudes. Oh, thank God. It's Gal Gadot and Dwayne Johnson, everybody.
Oh, thank God. It's a Jewish woman from Israel and a racially ambiguous man who identifies as a person of color. Here's a few more celebrities who, of course, always know what's best for us regular folks. Introducing the award for Best Actress.
And I am so happy to announce that the winner of this category will also receive the 23% of her salary that went missing in the wage gap.
That's true. That's correct.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, but you did hear that correctly. She did make a wage gap joke, falsely claiming that these poor actresses get paid 23% less than their men counterparts. Do I really need to waste my time debunking the wage gap myth again? It does not take into account differences in occupations, positions, education, job tenure, or hours worked per week. As this Time Magazine article so cleverly illustrates, when such relevant factors are considered, the wage gap narrows to the point of vanishing. But the wage gap myth insanity didn't end there. Here's what happened when they were announcing another award. This one, I think, was for Best Actor.
Yeah, these five nominees have agreed to give half of their salary back so the women can make more than them.
No, I don't.
No, that didn't happen. But the white male bashing didn't end there. Here's Natalie Portman announcing the winner for Best Director when it must be that time of the month for her because she decided to go off script and ruin the moment for the winner by sarcastically pointing out that no women were nominated for Best Director this year.
And here are the all-male nominees.
What a brave actress she is, standing up for women's rights. Oh wait, what's this? Oh, she was one of the celebrities who signed the petition supporting Roman Polanski. But thankfully, Oprah Winfrey was there to save the day, and maybe she could save the country, because she was given a special award for being a celebrity. Of course, everybody was talking about her tearful speech about how she could save America, but here's another speech that I think everybody missed, where she also discloses some of her plans to, quote, fix the country.
There are still generations of people, older people, who were born and bred and marinated in it, in that prejudice and racism, and they just have to die.
That's not exactly a very inclusive campaign message, Oprah. If you thought that this new year was going to bring an end to the insanity of the left, you were sadly mistaken. It appears that their sickness is only accelerating, and they're getting worse by the day. Get your liberalism find a care shirt from my online store at markdice.com or click in the link in the description below to help raise awareness of this devastating plague before it's too late. There's a variety of different styles and colors, so I hope you guys will check it out. You can click the link in the description below. It'll take you to the store. You can click on the link over here on the side of the video. Your purchase helps keep this channel going, so I appreciate your support. I'm Mark Dice. Thanks for watching. Subscribe here if you're new. Check back every day for a new one, and I'll see you tomorrow.